So we've all been carrying out these lateral flow tests, and let's take a look at what's inside one of these things then. So you can just open it up here with this bit here. Right, really simple. All this is essentially some pads and some nitrocellulose paper-like material. And we've got four main regions to this then. One, we've got the something over here called the sample pad, and that is where you deposit your sample that might contain virus particles. We've got something here, this red strip here, that is the conjugation pad. And what we've got here is a set of antibodies that are actually attached to gold particles, tiny gold particles, and actually tiny gold particles appear red. So that's why this pad is red there. So there's antibodies there that are labelled with gold particles, and those antibodies bind to virus particles. Down here, and we can't really see this, but roughly that lines up with the T line, we've got the primary antibodies that bind to virus. And then here, we've got a control line, and these are secondary antibodies, and they bind to the labelled antibody. Right, so how does this all work? Well, when we put a sample on here, it starts to wick up the lateral flow test, and the sample then pick up these red labelled antibodies. And those antibodies will bind to the virus. And some of them, of course, won't bind, but everything will carry on flowing up this pad. When they get to the T, the test line, the antibodies that are bound here will bind to the virus. So now we have the test, the antibodies that are stuck on the nitrocellulose, bound to the virus, that are also bound to the labelled antibodies that they picked up here, which means that that label, the gold label, gets stuck at that point there. Okay, so if you're testing positive, you'll get a red line appear here, there, because that's where the trapped antibodies will sit. Now, what we do, these things then carry on until they get to the control line. Now, this just is basically indicates that the test is working. And what happens now is that any of these antibodies that didn't get stuck here now get stuck there. Okay, and then anything remaining carries on to this pad at the end. So let's have a look at how that looks in action. So we deposit our sample at that S window. It quickly wicks up the device, picks up those gold labelled antibodies, and that then appears as that red smear in the second window. Any gold labelled antibodies that are attached to a virus stay at the T line. All the rest carry on moving and then get trapped at the C line. So that's a concentrated line of gold labelled antibodies at the C line. The remainder carries on up the device and gets deposited on a pad and at the end underneath that QR tag.